Yes, they drank a paint. What? Paint? How much? I don't know how much. Yes, hello. Welcome to the Matrixers. And we have a new exciting topic for you today. We hope anyway. We find it very exciting, because the current times are extremely exciting. And yes, we don't want to anticipate so much, I think. Today we want to try to make the video a bit structured. See if we can do it, because we think the topic is very complex. Yes. And today, there are three stages of global awakening regarding the situation in which we are all currently in this world. Stage number one. People are starting to distrust governments. It's no wonder that with the chaos of what's going on, and that every government works together. I mean, when did you ever experience that all governments are really under one roof? That everyone really played the game? And that is somehow very suspicious. So we have one or the other front out. And yes, it's not exactly what they are doing. But that's just what people noticed, especially through all the information. One says that, the other says that, the other says that again. There are now, I don't know, about 310,000,000 theories. Yes, there will be people. Then at some point, noisy, if one says that and immediately in the next second he reads the opposite. Yes, that's right. In any case, you have to say this point. You also say that all governments, or almost all governments on this planet, work together. And that also implies a cooperation. A global cooperation is possible, because a unified world government is actually not such a bad idea, theoretically. Yes, if it were, of course, constructive and good. For example, if there would be an attack by aliens, for example, then all people would stick together and just try to solve the problem of alien invasion together. Now, that's just hypothetical, but yes. Yes, and there would certainly also be a unified world government. Yeah, everyone would suddenly work together, although they have previously fought with each other. Or they weren't quite friends, they would be together now. Yeah, it's just like family. They always argue with each other, brother with sister, father with mother, grandpa with grandpa, but if someone comes from outside, then they all stick together very tight. Yes, you have already seen that with the series Married with Children. Yes, there is some truth to it. And it wouldn't be much different here on our planet. And therefore, I think a unified world government is a good thing. But NWO is a bad thing. Yeah, we don't want to rate it now, but you have to judge it by yourself. Yeah, because something like a new world order sounds like a dictatorship. So already a term. And this you can see according to the political situation in Germany. Yeah, how about LGU, loving global unity? So, yeah. That would be a nice shortcut. I also think so. LGE, or Eternal Peace on Earth, EPOE. Yeah, I think LGE is more appropriate, because in the end, it is what it will or should result in. Maybe not tomorrow, but LGU, loving global unity. Yeah, that would be a nice abbreviation and no NWO. So that sounds in the beginning threatening. So the first stage of global awakening, let's say, it's just that people are starting to distrust their current government or start to question them. Is that all right, what is done there? Are they allowed to do that at all? And where should it all go? So you start to question yourself, and of course the government's order, or the laws that are published there. And of course the people are all in a similar position, namely the one believes that what is done is good, the other thing that would be bad, and they initially shares the whole population. Yeah. So you can observe worldwide now, two camps have formed within the peoples. They just let each other stir up. You can see that with vaccination advocates and vaccination opponents, or the people who think the government's development is great, then those who don't like it. You can already tell that people are more divided than here. And of course, that's still part of its first stage. Quote of the day, we are not an endangered species yet, but it's not that we hadn't tried to become it often enough. By Douglas Adams. Yes, but through the lockdown, people are just discovering that this lockdown is really global, with very few exceptions like Taiwan and so on. Just realize that we are all in the same boat. We are all locked up. Some more, some less. Some have stricter restrictions, some less. But still everyone just choosing the same fate. They all choose to be locked up at home now. That was a huge deal. And that just connects people with each other. They find that we are all on the same boat. We all sit on the same ark, so to speak, and are locked up in the dark. Ark Gaia. Yes, in any case, this also increases solidarity among people. They are all against each other somehow, but at the same time you have to say that more and more people understand each other. You can disagree, it's okay. Then he just disagrees, but that says nothing about his personality. That doesn't mean that this personality is stupid or bad or has a bad character. He has a certain conviction that he is pursuing. And the conviction he has to not to be confused with his personality. And that's something that people are slowly beginning to recognize. I have the impression, namely, that we are all on the same level. There are only two levels. Either you are a citizen, or you are the head of government, or a high-ranking person in the government. So, for example, these are the two levels, so there is. And then you have to see what you belong to. And if you notice, oh, I'm a citizen, and it applies to all other countries, too, that I'm a citizen, then you can see who is sitting with whom in a boat. This also shows that compassion and empathy have increased a bit, because they feel for others as they do for themselves. For example, they are currently locked up, patronized or no idea. And that way they know that the other is doing the same. This means that they can emphasize with others the same thing. Yeah, right. This increases empathy, compassion for others, because you can also see in a dispute, yes, damn, he has a different attitude, but he's in the same situation as me. And that's when you start to realize that we are all in the same situation. And that promotes empathy, because we are all on one level. And that's the beauty of it. And you also have to say, because we are now in such a crisis situation, everyone starts to question everything. To question yourself, questioning others, and so on. And can get interesting results there. That is, by showing the dark side, the bright side is now always shown. Every coin has two sides. And if, for example, someone gets very greedy, any country, and want to make a lot of money, of course, he has to step into the light, saying here, I am greedy, I really want to have many billions. And then he has to show himself, yeah, that's the way it is. And then everyone else who sees him in the light can recognize, oh, that's his plan. And then you can decide whether you agree or not. Yeah, and just as it is outside, so it looks inside us. And simply because empathy increases more. And being emphatic means that you already have a certain frequency level, so to speak. Because otherwise, you would not to be capable of empathy. Yeah, through increased empathy and just frequency boost, and thereby the increased awareness and questioning the inside and outside, is of course much better to recognize the self, what is my shadow and what is my light. So you can feel empathy for yourself. And so it's actually about the circulation always a little higher, the spiral. And yeah, that happens to a lot of people too. And that's the effect we want to end up on. Everyone wants to go to 5D at some point. And most believe it will go from here to there in 3 seconds. No, it's not a Porsche from 0 to 110 seconds or in 3 seconds. Anyway, it's just a slow process. And a lot of people are going through that right now, triggered by this common global crisis, who are all inferior to speak. And yeah, everyone can see for themselves why it is like that outside. Because the outside mirrors the situation of all of humanity now and that of each individual actually. And yeah, I actually think it's pretty classy. As it is right now, everyone can now look at themselves. What does he feel by being locked up, for example? Can he handle it? Does it scare him or no idea? And that's all part of the first stage of global awakening. Stage number 2. Yeah, the second stage concerns the dispute with your own mortality, the personal examination of your own mortality. That means that a person is only afraid if he thinks his life is in any way fragile. And that's just the second stage, that you start thinking about your death. Thinking about it. Yeah, man, I'm mortal. I can die in such a crisis. Many were amazed that from one day to the next almost the government decided things like that. That somehow everyone gets house arrest and has to stay in the house as long as mom says, now you can go out again. Yeah, it is. So we are all children who have now received house arrest to follow what Mutti tells us then. That's the way it is. Pretty good. Yeah. And you can only get out of the house again if that has been done what mom says. That's the way it is. We know that from our childhood, then there was a week of house arrest. And only when we were really kind, we were allowed to go outdoor again. That's the way it is. Most people know what that is supposed to mean. That's why we don't need to mention it. Otherwise, this video will be blocked again. Yeah, mortality is a very exciting and important topic, I think, to deal with it. Not that's a real issue, but it's real for most people because we are all programmed that way, that we are mortal people. Yeah, if you have to fear for your life, then you start to think, what is the best to do now so that you can survive the whole story? That's the way it is. Yeah. And this time the danger comes from outside. Be it the virus for someone or for the other, a person who plans something with a lot of money to finish off everyone. So you don't know. No. Maybe there is also a third option. One does not know. You don't know. Yeah. And everyone can become aware of it. Become aware of his mortality. Sure, we believe in life after death. More and more people believe in life after death, that something will come after that, but it doesn't free us from the fear of dying. No, even if you know you are immortal, maybe you have already made out of body experience or something, and yet you can see that many people are still afraid of their own physical death. Yeah, there are still people. Okay, if they had all practiced out of body experiences now, maybe that would no longer be the case. But still, the life support drive is programmed on a biological level. It is included in the hardware. And yeah, it takes a while until you have overcome this fear of death. But it is very important right now. Yeah, because the fear and the knowledge that you are a mortal being or your life can quickly come to an end also mobilizes eternal skills. Yeah, exactly. This is true. By dealing with the fear, is it that you suddenly have a lot of more insights, because fear knows that is the way it is. So fear knows that you will die, otherwise you wouldn't be afraid of it. And yeah, that gives you a lot of insights. Yeah, and that is the basic prerequisite for the expansion of consciousness and the development of consciousness to deal with his fears. And since everything is based on fear, so all the dark sides are actually based on fear, you have a real big playing field here. So practically, or every emotion, every anger, whatever there is, this is basically based on fear. So you have enough to do if you want to. But now it's the time to deal with it, with all these fears and his own inner little demon kids. And yeah, I actually think that if people don't do this, it could be a bit of a shame for them, to say the least. So the time to do that is just now. Increase your frequency and look at your shadow. And yeah, we don't want to say more at first. Just the fear of death, or when it comes to life and death, and maybe the NWO who didn't really consider that, then you start turning to spirituality. Ah, yeah, that's right. And they probably didn't think about it that way. And they probably didn't consider that more and more people are now joining together. For example, you know that this country has a completely different culture and completely different attitudes and all that. That is what has been taught to us. Yeah, Turkey has its culture, and Japan has that culture, and China this culture, and India this, and we are also different and so on. We also have different languages. We don't even understand each other. But then you start to understand, oh no, they may have a different culture, but they are all thinking the same thing, maybe in another language. But that's all. They all have the same thoughts. They all have the same feelings. They also laugh at the same jokes, like us and so on. And now, more and more people are realizing that. And in a situation, in a crisis situation, where people are afraid, because they automatically have only the possibility to turn to spirituality at the end. Yeah, I also came up with an example. Because, for example, with the whole near-death experiences, if someone has a near-death experience, most change with means change their mind, but then they turn to spirituality, because they saw, oh, there is more to it than just being warm food. And dealing with fear and death now brings people much more into this expansion of consciousness and into spirituality, just like you say. Yeah, and that's just the second stage of awakening, global awakening. And stage number three, if you can lose everything, but you can accept that you can lose everything, then you have nothing left to lose. Yeah, that's the way it is. You come empty-handed and you leave empty-handed. Only in between do people believe that everything belongs to everyone. Yeah, one might think now that it has to do with material things. But it doesn't really have that either. Because once you've overcome the fears, or at least a large part, then you can't lose anything. And if you can't lose anything, then you are free. So that actually means freedom, to take these fears and integrate them into yourself. Integrate means to love and to get cozy with them, so to speak. And yeah, when you've lost your fears, for example, you didn't push it away, but actually brought it to yourself, then you can actually become free. Because in fear you are afraid of, namely, to lose something. It doesn't have to be just life. It can also be the house or the money that you can lose, or his gold treasure buried in the garden. So there are a lot of options that you are afraid of losing. And when you get so scared at some point, the peak of fear comes at some point, the highest point of fear. And at this point, you can see the other side of fear, at the highest point. And then you can see that you can't really lose anything. And then it's this highest point of fear. You can let go of fear. Can you let go of fear and just realize that you have nothing to lose? And if you have nothing to lose, then the courage comes. And what is necessary to let go of fear at the highest peak? Just it. Then accept the fear. Yeah. So to speak, devotion to fear. Because if you don't surrender to fear, but hold on to it, nothing will happen. Then you slide back, always up, down, to accept fear completely. And then you will see that you have nothing to lose. Or if you lost everything, then you just lost it. And then the courage comes. And courage only proves itself in the moment of the greatest fear. And then, when you let go of everything, you have a brave person in front of us who doesn't care about anything, because he knows that death is an illusion and he has nothing to lose. That is the third stage. Yeah, actually, that's really exciting that most people realize that they are not free at all, especially under the current situation that you are locked up at home. Let you see that you are not free. And only when you realize that you are not actually free, the path of freedom actually opens up for now. Because that is our goal, the ultimate goal anyway, to go to freedom, or as we would say, get out of the matrix. But because of the fact that you now admit yourself, yes, I'm not at all free, you can just start the path of freedom. That's how I would put it. What would you say? Yeah, you only want to be free when you realize that you are locked up. Exactly. And that's what is happening now. People recognize now, wait, you can just put me away. You can just banish me to house arrest. And I can only get out again when that's okay from above. Or the government, of course. And then you realize, yes, actually, I'm not really free. And I find that exciting in relation to yourself. And then you realize that you are not free in yourself either, that you are subject to all your programs or your behavior patterns, belief patterns, patterns in general, fears, emotions. So you are completely unfree in yourself. And that's what many people only recognize. So through the current situation, they notice that they are locked up from the outside. Oh shit, I'm actually inside myself, also a little locked up. And because of that, I think it's really important to deal with your own mini demons. Yeah, and only when you realize that you are not actually free, that the freedom you had was just an illusion, only then does the desire for freedom grow in people. And yeah, that happens in the third stage. Yeah, actually a very exciting topic, isn't it? Especially with fear and freedom. These are two, so to see, actually okay, freedom is actually not a pole. It's actually God's law, I'd say. But here, in the polar world, I think that are the two opposites, aren't they? Fear and freedom. Or what would you say? Yeah, correct. And freedom is behind fear. That's the way it is. Once you are through it, You see how free and really are as an immortal being. So that's an incredible feeling. And global awakening can be divided into these three stages, I would say. It doesn't mean that this would be the end. No, then it goes on. But we'll probably explain that in another video. Exactly, because there are different timelines. We are now on one timeline. The other timeline, however, looks very apocalyptic. And we were currently at a crossroad.
Verschiedene Zeitlinien. Wir befinden jetzt uns in einer Zeitlinie. Die andere Zeitlinie jedoch, die sieht sehr apokalyptisch aus und wir stehen gerade am Scheideweg.